Hello, this is CDS 8th grade boys team. We're going to present our Stay Afloat project right now. Our goal is the boat that has less area than 15 centimeters squared and that can hold more than 50 coins. The coins are 10-1.
Before we go over, how do boats float? It's basically because of Archimedes' principle and density of the boat. And the more water the more water displaces, then the buoyancy force will increase. So as the boat displaces water, then the buoyancy force will push boat up the water to make the boat float on the water. In addition, the boat's density is less than the density of the water. The boat is made out of steel, but the wide surface area and the empty space inside the water makes the boat's density less than the water's density. If the boat's density is heavier than the water, then the boat will dive in the water. However, the boat's density is lighter than the density of the water, so the boat can float on the water. So the key point is lighter density and the more displaced water.
So how do we make a boat stable? All we need to make a boat stable is balance of the boat, surface area, solidity, density, and holes are the key points for making it float balance. Stable balance of the boat will make the boat float on the water safely. Wide surface area will displace more water of the boat and make it float on the water. So solidity of the boat will hold the boat to keep its shape. Light density will make the boat not sink, and holes will not make the water go inside of the boat and make the density heavier than the water and make it sink.
Now we are going to introduce our boat designs. First design model name is ball, because it looks like a ball. This model has a deep, wide space inside. It looks like half square. It looks kind of unbalanced because of the bottom of the boat is not flat. Its mass is 8 grams.
Our second model's name is plate. It's called plate because it looks like a plate. It's really flat and wide. It doesn't have that much deep space inside, but it looks really balanced because of its wide, flat surface area. Its mass was 10 grams.
Our third model is a boomerang. It looks like a boomerang from the top, and it has 5 potholes, and it's wide and balanced because of its 4 wings, and the mass is 10 grams.
Our last model's name is UFO. It looks like upside down hat, and like a UFO, it has very deep space inside, and it has lots of space, like here, inside here, and it's balanced because of the flat, wide edges over here, and its mass is 9 grams.
Now we're going to show you an experiment video.
What?
Thank you. of that.
Thank you for listening on project presentation.
The conclusion says that all of our boats were lighter than the density of the core, and they were stable enough and strong enough to hold into point. Balance was good enough and solidity was good enough too. All of our models were successful. However, if we have to pick one best model, we think that the UFO made the best job. The bottom of the boat was stable enough, but the edges on top of the boat made the boat stable.
In conclusion, to make the boat float on water, the boat's density should be light enough to float, make it float, and it should displace lots of water. Balance, solidity, and surface area, and no holes are also important because it will make it float on the water. It will make it sink in the water if it's not good enough. If one is not good enough, if the boat is stable and light enough to float on the water, then holding the planes are not a hard problem to solve.
In our project, the best boat was design number 4, the UFO, because it showed the best stability. Like, in the inside, it has very deep space, so it displaces more water. And on the outer ring creates more surface area, so it kind of acts as like the balancer of the boat. So it did really good.
Thank you for listening to our project presentation.
Good job. Very good. Any questions, girls? No? Excellent, you guys. That's one of the best ones I've seen. What do you think?